Well, no random power outage or random internet outage that happened right after when I finish uploading a CCO game that an MLS team is involved. Looks like for once, we're actually going to do the review on time. Now, for Columbus, they did what they had to do in this game, which was get a big victory over Esteli, and they're pretty much now cement themselves into the quarterfinal of this competition. I mean, I know there is still a second leg to be played for, but you probably think there's no way Esteli was going to come back from a 4-0 deficit that they suffer against the Crew in the first leg. But the problem for the Crew is that they did suffer a couple of injuries to some of their players, and it's not just some of their players that they suffer for some injuries. These were key players on their team that unfortunately had to be subbed off with injuries, and we shall see in a couple of days when these guys are going to be reevaluated whether or not if these injuries is going to keep some of their key guys out for a bit. I mean, if you're a Crew fan, you hope that of course is not going to be the case. Now, in the first half and just 1 minute into this game, Rezano, the Esteli goalkeeper, had to call into action after he made a double save to deny Morris and Diaz on the follow-up. Then Rezano had to call into action again as he denied Diaz after it was really a direct ball play that was played, I think, from Zarayan to Diaz, and Diaz was trying to get the opening goal, but unfortunately his shot was just a little bit too weak and Rezano easily catch that. But you can clearly see it was a strong start from Columbus in the first 10 minutes, and they were rewarded with that strong start that they had early in this game with a goal in the 18th minute after Jerzy Czardas gave the Crew a 1-0 lead. And this was just an absolute gift that Czardas got. I mean, this not only was bad defending from Esteli, but they literally gave the ball away in the one area you do not want to give the ball away, which is right near the 18-yard box. Czardas basically say thank you very much, and he easily slots it into the back of net to give Columbus a 1-0 lead. Now, despite the fact that Columbus was leading in this game, the possession was actually 60 to 40 in favor of Esteli in the first 24 minutes. But despite the fact that Esteli had a lot of possession, they really didn't create much with that possession, and Columbus looked very lethal whenever they go on the counterattack. And then in the 25th minute, they would double that lead when Jonathan Mensah would score from Zarayan. And while this one was a goal coming from the corner, Mensah actually didn't head it this one. This one was him actually shoot this one with his feet, and I think he kind of mishit it a little bit, but somehow, even with that, the ball still was able to find into the back of the net, and Columbus, just like that, has a 2-0 lead. Now, there was a bit of a scuffle going on in the 27th minute, because why not? This is the CONCACAF Champions League after all. Then, in the 32nd minute, Czardas would score his second goal of the game from Diaz to make it 3-0 in favor of Columbus, and you just, at that point, feel like, yeah, the route is definitely on, and it's not really the question of whether or not if Columbus is going to win this game, but how many Columbus is going to get. And they had a big chance to get their fourth goal before halftime after a handball was committed by one of the Esteli players that gave Columbus a penalty. Now, if there is one thing that Columbus, you know, coming into this season might be a weakness, because, you know, there's really not a lot of weakness in this Crew team, but their one weakness I will say about this Crew team is taking penalties, because last season they really struggle in terms of that. And you know, you would think maybe Czardas was going to be stepping up to take this penalty to get his hat trick, but remember last year Czardas was 0 for 3 from the spot, and then you're also thinking maybe Zarayan would do it. Well, he also missed his only penalty that he took last season, so it was Santos the one that of course stepped up for this penalty. He actually went 2 for 2 from the spot last year, and he buries this one to make it 4-0 in favor of Columbus heading into the second half. Now, in the second half, I immediately wrote that, you know, with Columbus being so comfortable in this game, all they need to do is just keep their composure and hope no one get injured. Yeah, unfortunately, that did not happen. And, you know, throughout this game, you can clearly see Esteli, not only the fact that they know they're going to get blown out, but they're kind of started to feel like, you know what, we're just going to randomly kick a bunch of these Columbus player and hope that they of course get injured. And they were kind of showing some bad sportsmanship, which you usually see a lot of the case with some of the Central American team, especially the ones that are down big against an MLS opponent. Then in the 48th minute, Ilya Rome, who was relatively quiet up to this point, he absolutely robbed Barea, who had a free header there. That was probably the best chance that Esteli had in the entire game. Then Esteli started to kind of press a little bit to try to get a goal back before Zardes missed a big chance for his Hattie after he dragged a short range shot that just went wide, and this was actually coming off of a turnover from this Esteli defense. And then I also wrote Columbus was getting CONCACAF in terms of yellow cards. Like, the amount of yellow cards that Columbus got in this game, you know, it was a lot, but it was also so in some way that just kind of shows the referee clearly has a bias toward Columbus and clearly felt like, you know, if there is maybe one or two fouls that a Columbus Crew player commit, he's going to immediately go in the book. But on the other end, if there's an Esteli player commits a foul like four or five times, that's when, of course, he goes into the book. And probably the biggest evidence of why Columbus is just getting CONCACAF with a yellow card. Well, right around the 64th minute, Nagby actually fouled one of the Esteli player, but as he, of course, fouled one of the Esteli player actually pretty much kicked him in the leg, and basically Nagby was on the floor and also got a yellow card on that. Now, not only the fact that I don't think that was a yellow card, but because he kind of got kicked in the leg a little bit, he actually went down a little bit and went down again in the 65th minute and had to be subbed off what looks like a leg injury. And if you're a Crew fan, not only you are absolutely frustrated that this is the last thing you want, but I bet a lot of Crew fan was just absolutely fuming at the referee, and I don't blame them, because again, the referee in this game, they were very biased in terms of how they handled, you know, the yellow card. And you know, this is just the thing about CONCACAF referee, you know, sometimes they make some really bad decision, especially against MLS team, and we're unfortunately seeing the same case in this one too. Now, Rizzano in the 67th minute had to be called into action again after he denied Zarrion on the follow-up. He actually denied Zarrion. And then on the follow-up, Pedro Santos hit a volley that struck the post. And, you know, it looks like Columbus was trying to get that fifth goal because they were angry that one of their key players just got injured by one of the extended players. And they want retribution by adding another goal. But unfortunately, it did not happen. Then in the 77th minute, Santos himself had to be subbed off, and it looked like this one maybe is just a cramp that he of course suffered, but you know, you never know. You know, it seems like when he was about to went down, he kind of hold off his right calf a little bit, so maybe that could be a calf injury that maybe could keep him out for a couple of weeks. But you know, if you're a Crew fan, you hope that it's just a cramp and it's not actually a calf injury. Then Etienne also went down in the 87th minute, what looks like a knee injury. Now, he did stay in this game, although, you know, the reason why he did stay in this game isn't because he was fine and all, but Columbus was actually out of substitution at that point. And, you know, Etienne kind of had to limp his way for the final couple of minutes before the Crew, of course, gets a 4-0 lead. So, you know, if you're a Crew fan, you hope that Etienne, when he does get reevaluate, it's not going to be a serious injury. But like I said, in the end, the Crew was able to win 4-0 in this game. Shots in this one, as I actually forgot to talk about the shots in the Lyon versus TFC game. I mean, yesterday I was in such a hurry to get that review done because, you know, I was doing a review in a power outage and literally doing a review just a couple of minutes before the sun sets, and I was really relying on the sunlight outside to pretty much project the lighting of this video that I kind of rushed a little bit and forgot to talk about the stats. But in this game, in terms of shots, it was actually pretty even, 16-13 in favor of Columbus. 7 shots on goal compared to 5 that Esteli has, 6 shots off target compared to 2 that the Crew has, 2 shots that was blocked compared to 7 that the Crew had, and possession wise 51% possession compared to 49% possession that Columbus had in this game. So, you know, early on, Esteli, as I mentioned, they had a lot of possession, but eventually kind of evened out a little bit. And yeah, again, in the end, you know, Columbus, they'll be happy that they, of course, got this win. That pretty much means that they should be moving on into the quarterfinal, even with that second leg left to play. But the biggest bigger concern for Columbus in this game is how is the health of Darlington Nagbe, and you hope that Santos, when he suffered that injury, was just a cramp. And also, how is Etienne after he of course kind of limped through that last couple of minutes of this game. But yeah, there you have it. That is pretty much it for the review of this game. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think of this game? And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys next time.